Dr. Keith Black, chairman of the Department of Neurosurgery at Cedars Sinai. 15 years ago, my mother developed Alzheimer's disease, and she had a 10-year course and ultimately passed away from Alzheimer's. There are currently 5 million people with a diagnosis in the United States of Alzheimer's disease, and that number is going to go to 20 or 30 million by the year 2050. One of the main challenges is to be able to diagnose Alzheimer's disease before it becomes symptomatic. Because by that time, the disease has been going on for 20 years, the damage has already been done. The novel observation that we made is that the hallmark of Alzheimer's disease, these amyloid plaques that occur in the brain, also occur in the retina, which is an extension of the brain, which is at the back of the eye.
We were actually the first research team that identified the hallmark pathology of Alzheimer's disease in the retina, outside the brain.
We thought of the retina because it's part of the central nervous system.
The ability that we developed was a technique to allow us to see these amyloid plaques in the retina with very high resolution, very high clarity, with the non-invasive 10-15 minute eye test. There are many points where the test can actually be deployed. So it can be deployed, for example, in ophthalmologist offices, but it could also be employed in your health club.
It will allow a person to assess then if he wants to change the diet, change exercise, change the lifestyle.
When we ask someone to make a lifestyle change, it's not easy. You have to have a motivation. My motivation was watching my mother age and develop Alzheimer's disease, but also knowing the scientific facts that if I modified my lifestyle, I could basically modify my future. I developed a consistent exercise routine that I enjoy so that I keep it up all the time. I changed my diet to be much more like a Mediterranean diet that was rich in fish and nuts and vegetables and fruit, and much less so in red meat. I started watching how well and how much I sleep. We can have a much higher impact on Alzheimer's disease if we prevent patients from getting Alzheimer's disease and developing a medication to try to treat it once they develop it. Potentially, patients could be using the test by the second half of next year.